really intense laser beam and a receiver that can accommodate that, then that.
I'm Paul Jaffe from the Naval Research Laboratory, and I'm a researcher exploring solar power satellite technology. Today, I'm going to show you the scheme behind solar power satellites in which we collect the abundant sunlight of space and send it to places where we would need it on Earth. For our demonstration, we have the sun simulated by a lamp, the spacecraft, which has a solar panel and a wireless power transmitter, and on the ground, we have a power receiver, which we're showing here with a bunch of LEDs. So if I turn the sun on, powers up the satellite, and you can see that power is sent to the ground. Power is received, you can get a sense of where that power actually is in the beam with this. This may seem like mysterious high technology, but in fact, it is very similar to what you use every day with the Wi-Fi on your phone and other devices. An important thing to notice is that if a solar panel is on the ground and the sunlight is blocked by clouds, you don't get any power. The radio transmission that sends the power for solar power satellites will go through clouds uninterrupted, giving you a 24/7 base load source of electricity.